Maybe now you're done reflecting and figuring out whether you were actually stressed or not. Whether or not you were stressed right now, it is always good to know some stress management techniques that you could try out for yourself, just in case you will need it in the future. So in this video, we'll be going through some ways that you can manage some stress, and also some of my personal takes on what I do to manage when I'm stressed. Each and every one of us will have our own ways of managing stress, since of course no two individuals are similar. Thus, the stress management techniques that I'll be teaching will be somewhat basic, but also some things that you can easily test out for yourself. For the first one on our list, we might need to get a bit physical. It's called exercise. Being able to exercise at least 30 minutes per day would help improve your mood because your body would release hormones. One of these hormones are called endorphins, and they are chemicals released by the body to reduce stress and pain. Personally, doing more exercise actually helped me become more happier and less stressed during the day. Exercise can come in different forms. It might be a sport, running, jogging, swimming, and for me personally, I enjoy riding my bike. If you are not into physical activities, you can always do something simpler. You can clean your room and even just have a short walk. What matters here is you just expose yourself to enough sunlight. Sunlight will enable your brain to release a hormone called serotonin. Serotonin is a hormone that could help boost your mood and your focus, and that's enough to get us through the day. Alright, so let's say that now you have boosted your energy by doing some exercise and also by exposing yourself to some sunlight. After finishing all your tasks for the day, you will now need to go to our second way of coping with stress, which is what we call sleep. During the night, our brain is triggered to release a hormone called melatonin, which is responsible for helping our body sleep. When you sleep, your body tries to regulate some of its functions, and one of them is your appetite. Sleep also helps you process the information that you've learned during the day, and could also help you remember the future information that you'll be learning in the next day. The amount of sleep that you should be getting is a minimum of around 7 hours of uninterrupted sleep. For quality sleep, try to make sure that your room is dark, quiet, and cool. The third tip that I recommend is to connect with people you enjoy being with and socialize. This can be in the form of having lunch with them, drinking coffee, or even just having a simple phone call. Spending some quality time with the person you enjoy being with could most of the time help you feel more safe. When you're doing this, just keep in mind that this is the best time for you to unwind and find the reassurance that you need with the people that you enjoy being with. Well, maybe you're not the type of person who likes socializing. With this, my next recommendation is just for you, and it's called just having your own me time. There are basically different ways that you could try to do this. One thing you can try out is laugh therapy. In my case, laugh therapy is basically just watching a comedy series on Netflix. We have our own senses of humor, so I think this just depends on what makes us laugh. When you laugh, you take in more oxygen. When this happens, your heart, your lungs, and your muscles get the boost, and your body releases some feel-good hormones that could help you make your day a little better. Like I said, it depends on you on what you would like to do alone. You could try reading, try a new hobby, or listen to music. It depends on you. So just look for what fits. Lastly, one of the things I highly recommend people to do is to find someone that they could open up to about their experiences, preferably a professional therapist. I think it's better to have someone that you're comfortable opening up to because it gets you that safe environment where you can just say what you want, you know, what you feel, and have someone to listen to you. If you are not comfortable opening up to a professional therapist, you can always just look for a friend who's willing to listen to you and let you open up about what you're feeling. Like I said before, the stress management techniques that work for me won't necessarily work for you. That's why I think it's important that you test these things out and you figure out which one works for you the most. I think it's important to keep in mind that the simple act of recognizing and acknowledging that you're stressed and not okay is already a big step towards making better progress in terms of self-development. Now, after you acknowledge it, that'll be the time that you'll need to figure out the stress coping mechanism that works for you. Personally, what helped me keep track of my progress is journaling. What I did for that was I basically wrote down what I was feeling every day and tried to figure out what caused it. So some of the causes that I recognized were either work, school, or even my environment at home. And after that, I just recognized that and just found ways that I could cope better with it. And it was a long process, but I guarantee you that it will be worth it. Yeah, that's it for my tips on stress management techniques. You can search Google for some additional techniques. You can test them out for yourself and figure out what works for you and what doesn't. All right, I hope that the tips we gave you could help you out. And if ever you need someone to reach out to, you can always reach out to Positive Workplaces. That's it for this video. See you on the next one.